starting pitching, kind of what we thought we talked about last week, was kind of what we thought. I thought Davenport did a really good job. Came in, our pitching was very good, I thought, all weekend. And because they were a really, really good hitting team. And I think you'll see as the season goes on, for those guys, they're going to put up tremendous offensive numbers. And so I thought we did really good. And then we brought Brad Varell in, left-handed pitcher from Oklahoma. And he came in, I think it was five. Did he throw five shutout innings? And just he came in and gave us a chance to win the game. Held him there, just changing speeds. And he's one of those guys, new guys was talking about, that we're really excited about. And just pitched and held those guys off balance and did a good job there. And like I said, game one on Friday, pitched it well. Made a couple crucial mistakes late that hurt us. Weren't able to sustain anything offensively, and then it got into their back end arms, and they were pretty good, and then just shut us down. And kind of it was almost a mirror image on Saturday. Same thing, we make a couple of mistakes at the wrong time, they capitalize on it, and we just couldn't get it done. But I thought, once again, left-handed pitcher from Van Buren, Arkansas, Ty Callahan, did a tremendous job, did a good job. We make one mistake behind him, he leaves one pitch up, and all of a sudden it's a three-run inning. And that's how it went. We made a mistake. We could have got the third out of the inning. We didn't get it. Callahan leaves the first ball he leaves up the whole day. Guy hits it out of the yard immediately after there. And I just thought, you know, it's just one of those, it's kind of one of those things. We get bases loaded, get some things going, hit a ball hard, hit it right after shortstop, and they get a double play. So that was just kind of baseball right then. But the good thing to see was how we bounced back on Sunday. We came back on Sunday, and our guys really got after it and really started showing. I felt like on Sunday we started seeing, okay, the guys are starting to value more at-bats, our offense, how it works, patience in there as far as if they're going to give us a walk, we'll take it. You know, not coming out of our approach, coming out trying to be, you know, that's a hard thing for baseball sometimes is, you know, be the best version of yourself and who you are. Don't try to expand that. And sometimes that's hard to do, especially on the first weekend. So, but I thought we did a good job on that. And then, man, they were swinging it good on Sunday. And it was one of those games where we're sitting there thinking, well, we got to keep scoring. And that held true because they were putting, and we just kept doing it. And it seemed like every time we needed to add a run or something, Christian Brazier came up and delivered, did a good job. And Christian's been with us. He's a young man that was going to come to school here his freshman year anyway. We invited him to walk on. And next thing you know, he's starting at third base for us a couple of years later. So credit to him. And he did a really good job defensively also. But offensively, like I said, we got some things going. Finally got one out of the yard. That was one of the furthest home runs I've seen at our park from the right field side anyway, for sure. And so we put some things together. And then we bring in – and then same thing, started out a little slow and then brought in Connor Williams, who shut him down. And like I was telling you last weekend, we got guys that can throw fastballs and come with changeups. He's got a great split finger. That held him off balance for a while. They got things going and was able to bring in Matthew Patton, who got a huge double play. Come in, got a huge double play. And then, like I said, he's got a good fastball and a good changeup. If we wouldn't have had a plus-plus changeup guy, that game, I don't know, they may have scored 20, okay? It's kind of the way that game was going. So held it at bay, did a great job. Matt Patton, like I said, he's from Oklahoma Junior College and come in, just did a great job. DH for us also, and just held him back as long as we possibly, I mean, it was tough. And but we held in there, we fought together. There seemed to be a better sense of urgency, and we kind of figured out how to grab hold of a win and take it. And that was big, I thought, on Sunday, because that gives us momentum going into the week. We got a ton of things to work on, a lot of things to work on, but it's nice to come off a win after two losses, and it's tough losses, come on and get a win and then bounce us in and get ready for next week.